Today I discuss about classifications of breast cancer. In previous two video, I already told about what is breast cancer, risk factor of the breast cancer, pathophysiology and staging systems of the breast cancer. So now let's focusing on classifications of the breast cancer. Breast cancer classified depend on the combinations of histological patterns and cytological characteristic. So depending on those, the breast cancer can be divided into two groups: non-invasive carcinoma or cancer invasive carcinoma. Non-invasive carcinoma may also call carcinoma in situ, and invasive carcinoma may also call the infiltrating carcinoma. Non-invasive carcinoma or carcinoma in situ also divided into two types: ductal carcinoma in situ and lobular carcinoma in situ. This ductal carcinoma in situ also divided into two stages: ductal carcinoma in situ chemido subtypes, high grade, and non-chemido ductal carcinoma in situ. In other side, the invasive carcinoma or infiltrating carcinoma can also divided into two types: invasive ductal carcinoma and invasive lobular carcinoma. Invasive ductal carcinoma also divided into two types: non-specific invasive ductal carcinoma and specific invasive ductal carcinoma. And this specific invasive ductal carcinoma may also divided into some types. That's a medullary carcinoma, tubular carcinoma, colloidal carcinoma, inflammatory carcinoma, and Paget disease. These are all about the classifications of breast carcinoma. Now I discuss each types briefly. Let's focusing on non-invasive carcinoma or carcinoma in situ. What happened in this type carcinoma? In this type carcinoma, the malignant epithelial cell present in the duct or lobule and has not penetrated any basement membrane. An estimate find that 20% breast carcinoma is non-invasive carcinoma. Non-invasive carcinoma or carcinoma in situ was originally classified as a ductal or lobular based on the resemblance of involved the place or space to normal duct or lobules. So, based on involved space, the carcinoma in situ classifies two types: ductal carcinoma in situ and lobular carcinoma in situ. Now let's see what happened in ductal carcinoma in situ. By the name, we all are understood that it indicate the duct. So ductal carcinoma in situ is characterized by proliferation of malignant cell inside the milk duct without invasion of the surrounding tissue. That means it not spread to the lobules or stroma. So it indicated that ductal carcinoma in situ does not metastasize. This type of carcinoma can also develop invasive carcinoma if left untreated, and an estimates which indicate 43% of untreated ductal carcinoma in situ progress to invasive carcinoma over a period of 10 years or more. Management of ductal carcinoma can be controversial. Patients should discuss the treatment option with their healthcare provider, including breast conserving treatment like lumpectomy एंड मैसेक्टोमी विथ ब्रेस्ट रिकन्स्ट्रक्शन, रेडिएशन थेरापी एंड हॉर्मोन थेरापी लाइक टैमोक्सिफेन एंड एनास्ट्रोजोल. कार्सिनोमा इन सीटू इज कन्सिडर्ड ब्रेस्ट कैंसर स्टेज जीरो एंड इट्स फ्रिक्वेंटली मैनिफेस्टेड ऑन मैमोग्राफी एंड विथ एपरेंस ऑफ कैल्सिफिकेशन. डक्टल कार्सिनोमा इन सीटू इज डिवाइडेड इंटू टू सब टाइप्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन देयर आर्किटेक्चर. द सब टाइप्स आर डक्टल कार्सिनोमा इन सीटू केमेडो सब टाइप्स एंड नॉन केमेडो डक्टल कार्सिनोमा इन सीटू. इट इज हाई ग्रेडेड. इन डक्टल कार्सिनोमा इन सीटू केमेडो सब टाइप्स कार्स सेक्शन ऑफ द ट्यूमर शो डिस्टिंक्ट डार्क लाइक स्ट्रक्चर कंटेनिंग व्हाइट नेक्रोटिक मटेरियल सिमिलर इन अपीयरेंस ऑफ द केमोडोन्स. बट इन नॉन केमेडो डक्टल कार्सिनोमा इन सीटू वी शो इन द ट्यूमर द डक्ट कंटेन ए मैमोग्राफिक प्रोपेलेशंस ऑफ ट्यूमर विथ न्यूक्लियर ग्रेड रेंजिंग फ्रॉम लो टू हाई. इन दिस टाइप्स द ट्यूमर सेल एंड न्यूक्ली आर स्मॉल एंड मोर रेगुलर दैट दोज ऑफ केमोडो टाइप्स. ऑल अबाउट डक्टल कार्सिनोमा इन सीटू आई थिंक ऑल गाइज आर अंडरस्टूड इजिली. We move on lobular carcinoma in situ. This name indicate that it involves in the lobules. So, lobular carcinoma in situ is an accidental microscopic finding of abnormal cell growth in the lobules of the breast. It's also act as a risk factor for developing complicated carcinoma. A woman who affected the lobular carcinoma in situ, she should must undergo rigorous breast cancer surveillance, which contain annual mammography and every 6 month clinical breast examination. No surgical or radiation therapy is indicated for lobular carcinoma in situ, but the hormone therapy may be used as a preventive measure to reduce breast cancer risks for some patients. This is all about lobular carcinoma in situ. For quick recap, presence of malignant cell within the ducts or lobule is called as a non-invasive carcinoma or carcinoma in situ. In this diagram, we also differentiated between ductal carcinoma in situ and lobular carcinoma in situ. Okay, next we talk about invasive carcinoma. In this type carcinoma, the malignant cells that has penetrated through the basement membrane into the stroma. It's also classified into two types: invasive lobular carcinoma and invasive ductal carcinoma. Now I gonna focusing on invasive ductal carcinoma. Invasive ductal carcinoma is most common types of breast carcinoma. It's account for 80% of all cases. It start in milk duct and then break through the wall of the duct and invading the surrounding tissue. And it may metastasis to the other part of the body like lung, bone, liver and brain. According to morphological classification, the invasive ductal carcinoma may also classified into two types: specific types and non-specific types. 2/3 of breast cancer are classified into non-specific types. This name indicate that there is no specific cause for development of breast cancer. Another is specific types. About 1/3 of breast cancer आर क्लासिफाइड इंटू स्पेशल हिस्टोलॉजिकल टाइप्स। स्पेसिफिक टाइप्स ऑफ इन्वेसिव डक्टल कार्सिनोमा मे हैज वेरियस टाइप्स सच एस मेडुलरी कार्सिनोमा, ट्यूबुलर कार्सिनोमा, कोलोइड कार्सिनोमा, इन्फ्लेमेटरी कार्सिनोमा एंड पैगेट डिजीज। फर्स्ट वी टॉक अबाउट मेडुलरी कार्सिनोमा। मेडुलरी कार्सिनोमा अकाउंट्स फॉर अबाउट 5% ऑफ ब्रेस्ट कैंसर। इट टेंड टू बी डायग्नोस्ड मोर ऑफन इन वुमेन यंगर देन 50 ईयर्स ओल्ड। द ट्यूमर शो ए कैप्सूल इन द डक्ट एंड दे कैन बी बिकम लार्ज एंड मे बी मिस्टेक फॉर फाइब्रोइडिमा। इट्स मैनिफेस्टिंग विथ सेल दैट रिसेम्बल द मेडुलरी ऑफ द ब्रेन। द प्रोग्नोसिस इज ऑफन फेवरेबल। नेक्स्ट वी टॉक अबाउट ट्यूबुलर कार्सिनोमा। ट्यूबुलर कार्सिनोमा अकाउंट्स फॉर अबाउट 2% ऑफ ब्रेस्ट कैंसर। बिकॉज द एक्सिलरी मेटास्टेसिस आर अनकॉमन विथ दिस हिस्टोलॉजी। प्रोग्नोसिस इज यूजुअली एक्सीलेंट। माइक्रोस्कोपिकली इन्वेसिव डक्टल कार्सिनोमा इज ऑन टाइप एग्रेसिव डक्टल कार्सिनोमा कैरेक्टराइज बाय हाई रेट ऑफ एक्सिलरी लिम्फ नोड मेटास्टेसिस एंड स्किन इन्वॉल्वमेंट। कोलोइड कार्सिनोमा। कोलोइड कार्सिनोमा अकाउंट फॉर अबाउट 3% ऑफ ब्रेस्ट कैंसर। दिस टाइप्स कार्सिनोमा ऑफन प्रेजेंट इन वुमेन हु आर पोस्ट मेनोपोस्टियल ग्रेटर देन 75 ईयर्स ओल्ड एंड इन दिस टाइप कार्सिनोमा दिस कार्सिनोमा प्रोड्यूस म्यूसिन शो इट्स ऑल्सो कॉल्ड म्यूसिनस कार्सिनोमा। दिस टाइप कार्सिनोमा स्लोली ग्रोइंग दस द प्रोग्नोसिस इज मोर फेवरेबल देन द अदर मेनी। नाउ मूव ऑन इन्फ्लेमेटरी कार्सिनोमा। इन्फ्लेमेटरी कार्सिनोमा इज ए रेयर 1-3% एंड एग्रेसिव टाइप ऑफ ब्रेस्ट कैंसर। इट हैज यूनिक सिम्टम्स। द सिम्टम्स आर डिफ्यूज एडिमा एथमियो ऑफ द स्किन ऑफन रेफर टू एज ए प्यू डी ऑर्गेन रिसेम्बल एज ए ऑर्गेन पील। दिस टाइप कार्सिनोमा ऑकर ड्यू टू मैलिग्नेंट सेल ब्लॉकिंग द लिम्फ चैनल इन द स्किन एंड एसोसिएटेड मैस मे और मे नॉट बी प्रेजेंट। इफ देयर इज मैस इट इज ऑफन लार्ज एरिया ऑफ थिकनिंग। दिस टाइप कार्सिनोमा मे बी कॉन्फ्यूज विथ इन्फेक्शन बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स। इन्फ्लेमेटरी कार्सिनोमा कैन बी स्प्रेड टू अदर पार्ट्स ऑफ द बॉडी लाइक लंग ब्रेन बोन एंड लिवर। फॉर मैनेजमेंट केमोथेरेपी ऑफन प्ले एन इनिशियल रोल इन कंट्रोलिंग डिजीज प्रोग्रेशन बट रेडिएशन एंड सर्जरी मे ऑल्सो बी फॉलो। लास्ट टाइप्स इज पैजेट डिजीज। दिस डिजीज ऑफ द ब्रेस्ट अकाउंट फॉर 1% ऑफ डायग्नोस्ड केस ऑफ ब्रेस्ट कैंसर। इट इज कैरेक्टराइज बाय पर्सिस्टेंट लेशंस ऑफ द निप्पल एंड एरियोला विथ और विदाउट लेशन। इफ पैजेट डिजीज ऑकर इन एनी वुमेन द साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स आर इचिंग बर्निंग ब्लडी निप्पल डिस्चार्ज विथ सुपरफिशियल स्किन इरोशन एंड अल्सरेशन मे ऑल्सो बी प्रेजेंट। फॉर डिटेक्शन ऑफ दिस डिजीज पैथोलॉजिकल एग्जामिनेशन इज नेसेसरी। निप्पल चेंजेस आर ऑफन डायग्नोस एज ए इन्फेक्शन और डर्माटाइटिस व्हिच कैन लीड टू ट्रीटमेंट डिले। in management, the surgical removal of involved the tissue and radiation therapy may also be used. Now I talk about other types of invasive carcinoma, that is invasive lobular carcinoma. Invasive lobular carcinoma begin in the lobules of the breast and it can break out of the lobules and have the potential to the membrane to other area of the body. Invasive lobular carcinoma is a type of breast cancer that's usually appear as a thickening in the upper quadrant of the breast. In this type, carcinoma is positive for estrogen and progesterone receptor. This is all about invasive carcinoma. I think all guys are understood. We talk about clinical manifestation of breast cancer. According to the American Cancer Society, there are mainly 8 symptoms. The symptoms are, first, change in skin texture. The breast cancer causes change and inflammation in the skin cell that can be lead to texture change. Example of these texture changes are include scaly skin around the nipple and areola, as though the skin is sunburned and extremely dry. Skin thickening also present any part of the breast, which lead to itching, and it also causes the dermatitis. Next, nipple discharge. A person may observe discharge from the nipple, which can be thin and thick and can range in color from clear to milky to yellow, green or red. Next, dimpling. Skin dimpling can causes sometime be a sign of inflammatory breast cancer and aggressive types of breast cancer. Cancer cell causes a fluid build up in the breast and that's lead to swelling and as well as dimpling. Next symptom is lymph node changes. Lymph nodes are small, round and collections of immune system tissue that filter fluids and capture potentially harmful cell. This includes bacteria, virus and cancer cell. If the cancer cell live in the breast, the first place travel to the underarm lymph node region on the same side as the affected breast. Next, breast or nipple pain. Breast cancer can causes changes in the skin cell that lead to feeling of pain, tenderness, discomfort in the breast, although breast cancer often painless. Next, nipple retraction or inversion. Breast cancer can causes cell changes behind the nipple. These changes can result in nipple inverting or reversing inward into the breast, or it may look different in terms of its size. Other symptoms is redness. Breast cancer can causes change to the skin that may make it appear discolored or even bruised. The skin may be red or purple. Last symptom is swelling. Breast cancer can causes the entire breast or an area of the breast to swell. There may not be distinct lump after this swelling, but the breast may be different in size than the other breast. So, this is all about clinical manifestation of breast cancer. These all are important not ignore any signs or symptom that could be due to the breast cancer.